Hello again, and welcome to American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem, and we're all set to count down the biggest hits in the USA. According to the official Billboard survey, these are the records that you're buying and radio stations are playing all over America. Now, before we start our countdown to the number one song in the land this week, let's review the top of the chart a week ago. Last week, the number three song was Stop Dragging My Heart Around by Stevie Nicks with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. The number two hit, Juice Newton's Queen of Hearts. And number one last week was this song. The smash duet by Diana Ross and Lionel Richie. Endless Love, the number one song in America last week. In fact, it's been the number one song for the past 6 weeks. Has it held on for a seventh week? We'll find out when we reach the end of our countdown today on American Top 40. The countdown which starts in just a moment.
Casey.
Now we're all set to count down this week's 40 most popular songs, including three debut records. And here we go.
Number 40.
Superstar Billy Joel debuts with a live version of a song that originally appeared on his 5-year-old album, Turnstiles. Here's Say Goodbye to Hollywood, Billy Joel.
Bobby's driving.
32-year-old Billy Joel debuting at number 40. His latest hit is Say Goodbye to Hollywood. I'm Casey Kasem on American Top 40 saying hello from Hollywood this week as we continue the countdown with a song at number 39. That's where it was last week by the Allman Brothers, and that's where it is this week, Straight from the Heart. Survey song number 39 again this week, the Allman Brothers Band and Straight from the Heart. A listener in Louisiana wants to know how many songs during the rock era have entered the Hot 100 Singles chart in the top 10 their first week on the chart. Well, after 26 years and more than 3,000 top 10s, only three recording acts have ever done that. Details coming up.
The hits from coast to coast. American.
Superstar John Denver's last hit was My Sweet Lady. That was 4 years ago. His latest, Some Days Are Diamonds, drops two notches this week to number 38.
When you ask, some days are diamonds.
John Denver falling from 36 to 38 with Some Days Are Diamonds. This is Casey on American Top 40 in Hollywood. And now we're up to that question about songs debuting in the top 10. It comes to us from Wayne E. King in Gretna, Louisiana, and he wants to know how many songs during the rock era have ever entered the top 10 their first week on Billboard's Hot 100 Singles chart. Well, of the more than 3,000 top 10 songs during the rock era the past 26 years, only three acts have had the power to do that, to put songs in the top 10 first week on. Now, the first came in April of 1958, when Elvis Presley's Wear My Ring Around Your Neck landed at number 7 its first week on the chart. The very next month, in May 58, Sheb Woolley's novelty tune, The Purple People Eater, entered at number 7 in its first week on the chart. Now, no other recording act hit the top 10 their first week on the pop chart till 10 years later. That's when a British act performed The Incredible. They debuted in the top 10 3 years in a row. The first time was September of 1968 with Hey Jude, which entered the chart at number 10. Then in May 69, they did it with Get Back, which also entered the chart at number 10. Finally, this act debuted an unparalleled third time with Let It Be at number 6 in 1970. The act, of course, the Beatles. So there's your answer, Wayne. Five songs have entered the top 10 their first week on Billboard's Hot 100 Singles chart. One by Elvis, one by Sheb Woolley, and that record-setting three by the Beatles. And you know what? It hasn't happened since the Beatles did it back in 1970. Thanks for writing. Now, on with the countdown.
Number 37.
Pat Benatar's latest hit peaked at number 17 a couple of weeks ago, dropped to number 30, now at number 37. It's from her number one album, Precious Time. Pat Benatar with Fire and Ice. ninth week on the chart, falling from number 30 to number 37, Fire and Ice by Pat Benatar. 36 big hits to number one, and we're counting them down.
Casey's, Casey's, Casey's Coast to Coast, American Top 40.
AT40 originates in Hollywood. Gary Wright peaked at number 16 with his song. Moving down now, stopping at number 36, here's Really Wanna Know You. Gary Wright's third Top 40 hit is now at number 36 in the countdown on American Top 40. It's Really Wanna Know You. Every week, AT40 is heard in the 50 states and around the world on great radio stations like WAKQ, Russellville, Kentucky, KAYS, Hayes, Kansas, and WABI, Bangor, Maine. I'm Casey Kasem. We're up to number 35 in the countdown now. The last time singer Carl Carlton was here was in 1974 when he hit number 6 with Everlasting Love. This week he debuts at number 35 with She's a Bad Mama Jamma. Carl Carlton, that's the number 2 soul song in the USA this week, and at number 35 debuting on American Top 40, She's a Bad Mama Jamma. Up next, the only song about a soap opera ever to hit the 40.
Casey, Coast to Coast,
here's the only song about a soap opera ever to hit the top 40. Up a notch to number 34, The Afternoon Delights with General Hospital. The Afternoon Delights from Boston at number 34, third week on the chart, moving up a notch with General Hospital. You know, we often hear of American artists who've had to hit first in Europe before they clicked with audiences here at home. Well, we know an entire record company who had to hit big in Europe in order to break the ice in the USA. And their first Top 40 hit is coming up.
The hits from coast to coast, American.
We're on our way to the number one song in the land and counting down.
Number 33.
The latest hit by composer, conductor, and producer Quincy Jones features vocalist James Ingram. Up 5 notches this week to 33, here's Just Once. Quincy Jones featuring James Ingram at number 33, moving up 5 notches second week on the chart with Just Once. In the Bible, the book of Matthew tells us that a prophet is not without honor except in his own land. Well, sometimes that's how it is for a performer or a record company. Consider the case of Tiny Berserkly Records, a label based in Berkeley, California. They just weren't making it here in America. Berserkly artists like the Greg Kinn Band, Jonathan Richmond, the Rubinews, and Earthquake were all popular in the San Francisco Bay Area, but Berserkly just couldn't seem to get them off the ground in the rest of the country. They tried a distribution deal with Playboy Records, but their contract was dropped after a year. So they signed another deal with GRT Records, and that company went out of business. Very frustrating for the people who ran Berserkly Records. So frustrating that they gave up on the USA and tried to make it in the European market. They opened a small office in London, and wouldn't you know it, within a few months, recording acts on the Berserkly label had hits in the top 5 on the record charts of England, France, Belgium, Germany, and Holland. In fact, a song by the Berserkly artist Jonathan Richmond became so popular in England that his song called Egyptian Reggae became the closing theme on England's BBC Two radio network. Well, Berserkly Records finally came home a couple of years ago. They signed a new American distribution deal with Elektra Records. And finally, the Berserkly label has been carried into the top 40 for the first time in its existence. And the man who broke the ice for him is Greg Kinn. Here he is with the Greg Kinn Band at number 32 now, with a song that peaked at number 15, the breakup song. The Greg Kinn Band on American Top 40, they fall from 17 to 32 in the countdown this week with The Breakup Song. Now, from the AT40 Archives. another of the number one songs of the 60s. We're reviewing them all from January 1960 to December 1969, and we're up to March 1968. This was the 178th number one single of that decade, The Dock of the Bay by Otis Redding.
Sitting in the morning sun.
In our weekly review of all the number one songs of the 60s from the AT40 archives of March 1968, that was Otis Redding with The Dock of the Bay, Billboard's 178th number one single of the 60s. Coming up in our next hour, the current hit by a former Motown vocal group whose lead singer has been turning down offers to record as a solo artist for 27 years. This is American Top 40 in Hollywood, California, counting down the most popular songs in the USA. I'm Casey Kasem. We'll continue in a moment. 31 big hits to go to the number one song in the land. This is American Top 40 in Hollywood. I'm Casey Kasem, and our official weekly review of the 40 most popular songs in America rolls on.
Number 31.
The last time Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band were in the countdown was a year ago. They hit number 14 with You'll Accompany Me. This week, Bob Seger's got the highest debuting song in the survey. Coming in at number 31, here he is with his live recording of Trying to Live My Life Without You. Trying to Live My Life Without You. Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band debut at number 31 with that song. This is Casey Kasem on American Top 40. Now we're up to a hit by that former Motown vocal group whose lead singer keeps getting offers to record as a solo performer. And he's been getting them for 27 years now. But the only kind of contract he'll sign or has ever signed has included his three partners. The same four original members have been taking care of business as a group ever since they got together in Detroit way back in 1954. Their basic training was 10 years of club and theater dates and some R&B recordings. Then in 1964, they signed with Motown and immediately had their first pop hit. Baby, I Need Your Lovin'. That was the start of an 8-year string of top 40 hits on the Motown label, including the number one records, I Can't Help Myself and Reach Out, I'll Be There. Then, in late 1972, this group went to ABC Dunhill Records, where they continued to get hits. Their biggest record for that label was a number 4 smash, Ain't No Woman Like the One I Got. Now, more recently, this four-man act signed with Casablanca Polygram Records, and they're back on the charts. Back on with their 23rd Top 40 hit. A very strong argument for sticking together. At number 30 this week, here are Lawrence Payton, Abdul Duke Faker, Ronaldo Obie Benson, and the man who won't sing without his buddies, Levi Stubbs. Together, they're the Four Tops. The Four Tops moving up 7 notches to number 30 in the countdown, second week on the chart with When She Was My Girl. And the countdown continues.
The hit from coast to coast, American Top 40.
AT40 originates in Hollywood. And here's a rock band that originates in San Francisco. It's the five men who call themselves Pablo Cruz. 2 weeks ago, they were at their high point at number 13. Last week, fell to 16. This week, at number 29 with Cool Love.
A room full of faceless strangers.
Pablo Cruz on American Top 40 at number 29 with their fifth Top 40 hit. That's Cool Love. You know, over the years, we've spoken to some artists who learned how to be singers and others who swear they were born to be singers. Like Kim Carnes, who recently told us, quote, "Nothing came from my family or from anyone that I knew. I always sang. As far back as I can remember, I knew I was going to be a singer. It must have been born in me." At number 28, here's born singer Kim Carnes with Draw of the Cards. Kim Carnes at number 28, second week in a row, fifth week on the chart with Draw of the Cards. Coming up on American Top 40, a long-distance dedication from a girl in Ohio to the man who took her on her first date and gave her her first kiss.
Casey's Coast to Coast, American Top 40.
You're listening to the countdown of this week's most popular songs.
Number 27.
Up six notches to 27, jazz vocalist Al Jarreau with his first pop hit, We're in This Love Together. Al Jarreau's first pop hit on American Top 40 at number 27, moving up six notches. We're in this love together. I'm Casey Kasem on American Top 40. You know, many of the long-distance dedication letters that come in every week ask us to play a hit song that is directly tied into the writer's personal life. Like this one from a girl in Wellsville, Ohio. She writes, Dear Casey, for 2 years I had been looking for a man I saw in my head as the man of my dreams, my true love. Last September, I met a man who was just about everything I was looking for. He took me on my first date, gave me my first kiss. He was my first everything. I told him I loved him, but he told me he didn't think it was real, and he only loved me as a friend. I've gotten to know other men, and I've been with other men, but I always wished they were him. I know that my love is for real. I've tried to forget him, but I cannot. Only one thing about him bothers me. He said we were only friends, but he was very jealous of my other male friends. His face, his actions, and his words give him away. I've never cared about anyone else and only turned to the others because I was lonely. One night after we first met, he told me to listen to a song on one of his tapes. Maybe I misunderstood what he wanted me to get from the song. But every time I hear it, I get the same meaning. I know this dedication won't change things between us, but I want to dedicate that song to him wherever he may be, Ohio, Kansas, or somewhere else. My long-distance dedication goes to Keith, and it's How Much Love by Leo Sayer. It comes from Debbie in Ohio. Okay, Debbie, here's your long-distance dedication. From 1977, that's Leo Sayer with How Much Love, a long-distance dedication from Debbie in Ohio to Keith. I'm Casey Kasem on American Top 40. We've got 26 big hits to go to the number one song in the USA.
It's from coast to coast, American Top 40.
Moving up five notches to number 26 this week, here's a song written by San Franciscan Sammy Hagar and sung by Australian Rick Springfield. I've Done Everything for You. Rick Springfield's third week on American Top 40 with his follow-up to Jesse's Girl, a number one song. This one is now at number 26, and it's called I've Done Everything for You. You know, we've mentioned in recent weeks that Joey Scarberry, who's currently in the countdown with his first Top 40 hit, made an appearance in the Hot 100 way back in 1971 with a song called Mixed Up Guy. Joey was 16 years old then, and I'd like you to hear a little bit of his first chart record. Here he is, Joey Scarberry. 10 years ago.
Oh, why did you have to get so mixed up, baby? With a mixed up guy. With a mixed up guy like me.
That song got as high as number 73. Joey Scarberry's current hit, climbing all the way to number 2 a few weeks ago, is now at number 25 in the countdown. The theme from Greatest American Hero, Believe It or Not. Joey Scarberry falls from 15 to 25 with theme from the Greatest American Hero, Believe It or Not. A listener in the Philippines wants to know if any all-white groups have ever hit number one on the soul chart. Oh yes, there's a total of 8 white groups who've placed number one hits on the soul chart. Details coming up.
Casey's Coast to Coast, America.
American Top 40 is heard in the 50 states and around the world every week on great radio stations like WATN, Watertown, New York, WATT, Cadillac, Michigan, and KAVL, Lancaster, California. I'm Casey Kasem. Last week's highest debuting song moves up five notches to number 24 this week. Dan Fogelberg from Boulder, Colorado, and Hard to Say.
Lucky to love you.
30-year-old Dan Fogelberg at number 24, second week in the countdown on American Top 40 with Hard to Say. Well, now we're up to that question about White Axe on the Soul Chart. Comes to us from Carlos Munoz in Santa Cruz, Pampanga in the Philippines. He wants to know if any all-white groups have ever hit number one on the Soul Chart. Well, we found eight acts that have performed that feat. First, there's Bill Black's Combo. They hit with Smokey Part 2 back in 1960. In 1978, the group Foxy took Get Off to the top of the Soul Chart. And there are six all-white groups who hit number one on the Soul Chart and the Pop Charts with the same songs. In 1957, there was At the Hop by Danny and the Juniors. In 1958, Little Star by The Elegants. In 62, Sherry by The Four Seasons. In 1963, Hey Paula by Paul and Paula. And Sugar Shack by Jimmy Gilmer and the Fireballs. Finally, in 1976, there's Play That Funky Music by Wild Cherry. So there's your answer, Carlos. Eight all-white groups have hit number one on the Soul Chart. Thanks for writing in. Now, on with the countdown.
Number 23.
Now, here's a man who's hit the top 40 on the Soul Chart 10 times, and this is his third top 40 hit on the Pop Chart. It's Rick James singing about a lady he not too gallantly calls Super Freak. Rick James' third top 40 hit is now at number 23, moving up three notches, and it's called Super Freak as the countdown continues. You're listening to this week's 40 Top Tunes in the 50 States. And the song at number 22 is by a new band called Balance. They're from New York City, and they climb a notch with Breaking Away. Moving up one notch from 23 to 22 on American Top 40, seventh week on the chart, Balance, the group's first hit, is called Breaking Away. Now, from the AT40 Archives. Another of the number one songs of the 60s, and we're up to April 1968. This was the 179th number one single of that decade, Honey, by Bobby Goldsboro.
See the tree, how big it's grown. The first day that she planted it was just a twig.
In our weekly review of all the number one songs of the 60s from the AT40 archives of April 1968, that was Bobby Goldsboro with Honey, Billboard's 179th number one single of the 60s. Have you ever heard of such a thing as a number one jinx? Well, there's a band in the countdown who've had nothing but bad luck after getting their first number one album. Bad luck ranging from wrong turns to stolen songs. Details coming up in just a few minutes. I'm Casey Kasem. This is American Top 40 in Hollywood. We're counting down the week's 40 biggest hit singles, and we're 21 hits away from the number one song in the land. We'll continue in a moment. Now, as we continue our countdown of the 40 biggest hits in the country, I'd like to welcome a new station to the American Top 40 family. It's WMSQ in Havelock, North Carolina. Great to have you with us. My name's Casey Kasem, and we're doing our weekly survey of the most popular records in the USA, and on we go.
Number 21.
The last hit for Scottish singer Lulu was Oh Me, Oh My, I'm a Fool for You, Baby. It peaked at number 22 way back in 1970. Her latest single just passed it by moving up a notch this week. At number 21, here's Lulu with I Can Never Miss You More Than I Do. Lulu at number 21 on the countdown, moving up a notch with I Could Never Miss You. This is American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem. You'd think that when an act hits number one, Lady Luck is smiling on them, right? Well, the lady seems to be laughing at REO Speedwagon. Several months ago, this popular rock band hit number one on the album chart. It was their 11th album, but their first number one. The title is High Infidelity, and it spent a total of 15 weeks at number one. Sounds like 15 weeks of very good luck for REO Speedwagon. But according to the group's lead singer, Kevin Cronin, the luck didn't run over into the rest of the band's life. He says that as soon as High Infidelity hit number one, strange things began to happen. Quote, it all started when we rented a limo to take us from Philadelphia to New York. But the driver took a wrong turn and we ended up in Atlantic City. Then we had to get to Athens, Ohio for a concert. So we rented a jet. And halfway there in the middle of a storm, one of the engines stopped dead. To make matters worse, when the pilot tried to land the plane, he missed the runway on the first pass. That's Kevin Cronin talking, and there's more. Kevin says, that night when I got back to my hotel room, I found someone had smashed the door in and stolen all my notebooks and the songs for the next album. In my opinion, fate wasn't smiling on us, it was hiccuping on us. End of quote. And from the way Kevin told his story, I get the feeling that REO Speedwagon would happily repeat those episodes for a number one album any day. At number 20, here's REO Speedwagon with the fourth hit off High Infidelity, In Your Letter. REO Speedwagon at number 20, moving up a notch with their fourth top 40 hit from the album High Infidelity. Coming up, the 19 top tunes in the USA. Billboard ranks them and AT40 counts them down.
Number 19.
Superstar Kenny Rogers' last hit was I Don't Need You, which went to number 3 in August. Now here's the follow-up single. Up 6 notches this week to 19, Share Your Love. Kenny Rogers debuted at number 25 last week. This week he moves up to number 19 with Share Your Love. Coming up, we'll identify the most successful Australian-born male singer, female singer, and group ever to make the American charts.
Casey's Coast to Coast, American.
Star recording duo Daryl Hall and John Oates have had 12 top 40 hits. 5 of those have made the top 10, including 2 number ones, Rich Girl and Kiss on My List. Their current single makes the biggest move on the chart this week. It jumps up 9 notches to number 18, Private Eyes.
I see you, Private Eyes.
Daryl Hall and John Oates, third week on the chart, already at number 18 on American Top 40 with Private Eyes. Now, let's see who are the most successful native-born Australians when it comes to hitting the American charts. Man, woman, and group. Now, the most successful Australian-born man to hit here earned that reputation in just the past couple of months, mainly on the strength of his number one smash, Jessie's Girl. He's also had Speak to the Sky, which hit number 14 in 1972, and his latest hit, I've Done Everything for You. By now, you know I'm talking about Rick Springfield. The female singer born in Australia who's had the most success on the U.S. charts is also the top native Australian act on the American charts overall. In the past 10 years, she's placed 14 hits in our top 40, and 3 of them went to number 1. I Am Woman, Delta Dawn, and Angie Baby. And the artist, of course, would be Helen Reddy. Now, the most successful Australian-born group on the U.S. charts are a 6-man band who have hit our top 40 8 times. And 4 of those hits made the top 10. Their biggest in 1978 was a song called Reminiscing. It hit number 3. Their other top 10s were Lady, Cool Change, and Lonesome Loser. The group, the Little River Band, and they're just a few points ahead of their closest rival, Air Supply. But they're holding on to the lead thanks partly to their current hit, The Night Owls. It's up 3 notches this week to number 17. Here's the American chart's most successful Australian-born group, The Little River Band. Moving from number 20 to number 17 on American Top 40, The Little River Band and The Night Owls. I'm Casey Kasem on AT40 in Hollywood. The 5-man band formed in Birmingham, England, and now based in London, climbed 2 notches to number 16 with their current hit. It's called The Voice, and they're called The Moody Blues. The Moody Blues singing their 10th top 40 hit at number 16 this week, moving up 2. It's called The Voice, as the countdown continues.
The hits from coast to coast, American Top 40.
A couple of songs back, we mentioned the most successful native-born Australian male vocalist on the American charts. And here he is with his recent number 1 song, now at number 15, Rick Springfield.
Jesse is a friend.
There's the oldest record in our countdown. 21 consecutive weeks on American Top 40. 2 of those weeks at number 1. Now at number 15, Jessie's Girl by Rick Springfield. Every week, American Top 40 is heard in the 50 states and around the world on great radio stations like WBBF Rochester, New York, WBBO Forest City, North Carolina, and WBCM Bay City, Michigan. I'm Casey Kasem. The third Top 40 hit for Sheena Easton moves up five notches to number 14. It's For Your Eyes Only from the James Bond movie.
For your eyes only.
Sheena Easton's at number 14 in our countdown, moving up five notches with her third Top 40 hit, For Your Eyes Only. Now, listen to this.
Pretending you were mine.
Someday you'll open up your eyes.
That's a piece of the only hit by any black group ever to hit the Top 40 on the country chart. Their song also hit the pop chart, but it never hit the soul chart. Details are on the way.
Casey's Coast to Coast. American Top 40.
Brian, Carl, Dennis, Mike, and Al climb a notch to number 13 this week with a medley of eight of their hits. They're the Beach Boys. The Beach Boys and the Beach Boys medley on American Top 40 at number 13 in the countdown, moving up a notch. Now, we're up to the latest hit by the only black group in history to ever hit the country top 40. Listen to this. The only record by a black group ever to hit the country top 40. The country chart is familiar territory to black solo singers like Big Al Downing and Stoney Edwards, O.B. McClinton and superstar Charlie Pride. But black groups have never really aimed at recording country music, and neither did this one. They're a sister act who first got started on the pop and soul charts back in 1973. Then in 1974, they released a single called Fairy Tale, which to most everybody's surprise, debuted on Billboard's country chart 2 months before making the pop chart. Eventually, Fairy Tale hit number 37 on the country chart and number 13 on the pop chart. But it never even appeared on the soul chart. And that song was the first and is still the only hit by a black group ever to make the top 40 on the country chart. It's by the Pointer Sisters, and that happened 7 years ago. And now, here are the Pointer Sisters today with a song that's a big hit on the pop and soul chart. At number 12 on American Top 40, after peaking at number 2, here's Slow Hand. The Pointer Sisters have kept Slow Hand in the top 10 for 11 consecutive weeks. This week, they fall from 10 to number 12. Next up, ELO's current single in which they sing Accroche-toi à ton rêve. We're 11 hits away from the number one song in the USA and counting down.
Number 11.
The current hit by ELO has a verse that goes Accroche-toi à ton rêve. That's French for hang on to your dream. The song climbs a notch to number 11. It's called Hold On Tight. ELO on American Top 40, one step away from the top 10 at number 11 with Hold On Tight. Now from the AT40 archives. Another of the number one songs of the 60s, and we're up to May 1968. This was the 180th number one single of that decade, Tighten Up by Archie Bell and the Drells.
Hi, everybody!
In our weekly review of all the number one songs of the 60s from the AT40 archives of May 1968, that was Archie Bell and the Drells with Tighten Up, Billboard's 180th number one single of the 60s. My name's Casey Kasem, and this is American Top 40. Our countdown of the most popular hits in the USA continues in a moment. We've got the 10 biggest hits coming right at you. Now on with our countdown of the 40 biggest hits in the USA. I'm Casey Kasem, this is American Top 40, and we're on our way to the number one song in the land.
Number 10.
Here's a band that first hit our pop charts the same year the Beatles did, back in 1964, and they haven't stopped since. Their latest hit is from their ninth number one album, Tattoo You, the current number one album in the USA. The Rolling Stones with Start Me Up.
Yep.
The Stones, first week in the top 10 with their latest at number 10, moving up a notch. It's called Start Me Up. You're listening to American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem. The latest hit by the Commodores peaked at number 8, stayed there for 3 weeks, and is now dropped to number 9. It's their 14th Top 40 hit. Lady, You Bring Me Up. Last week at number 8, this week at number 9, the Commodores on AT40 with Lady, You Bring Me Up. Coming up, a long-distance dedication from a woman in Tokyo to her family to help them understand why she can't settle down.
It's from coast to coast, American Top 40.
The latest hit by country and pop star Eddie Rabbit has been true to its title. It's called Step by Step, and over the last 3 weeks, it's been climbing step by step. From number 10 to number 9, now to number 8.
She seems a million miles away. That's the right treat like a lady.
Eddie Rabbit's third week in the top 10 at number 8 as we count down the 40 biggest hits in the USA. That was Step by Step. This is American Top 40 in Hollywood. I'm Casey Kasem. You know, the long-distance dedication requests that come in every week are from near and far. They're from all over the world. And here's one from a listener in Tokyo. She writes, "Dear Casey, my sisters and brother and I have had a childhood different from most other children. We traveled and moved around a lot because of my father's job. Keeping Japan as the home base, we would leave for 1 or 2 years to other countries. Many people have envied us. But when we were younger, we would have given anything to stay in one place forever. It was hard to leave friends and learn new languages, but it has made our family close. As we grew older, we were put in different schools and our worlds changed. At one time, one sister was in Amsterdam, one in Vancouver. My little sister and brother were in Tokyo, and I was in Manila. The two older ones have finished university. One is happily married and living in Canada. The other plans to marry this autumn and work as a school teacher in Vancouver. I've tried going to university, but just felt that it was a waste of time and money. So I got an excellent paying job as a secretary in a big international company in Tokyo. I lasted only 2 months there. Then I packed my bags and sort of went everywhere, from Tokyo to the States and on to Europe, working wherever I was in order to buy my next ticket to go on. And I love it, seeing and experiencing so many things. I've just arrived back in Tokyo and got a job with a band as a vocalist. My parents don't understand why I don't continue my studies or get a good job. When talk of marriage comes up, I tell them that no way can I see myself settle down. I wish so much that I could make my family understand that I'm happy now. Casey, if you could play The Wanderer, dedicated to my family, maybe they'll understand me better. It's my theme song, just the way I feel. Signed, Carla." Okay, Carla, here's your long-distance dedication. From last year, that's The Wanderer by Donna Summer, a long-distance dedication from Carla in Tokyo, Japan, to help her family understand why she can't settle down. And the countdown continues on American Top 40.
It's East Coast to Coast, American Top 40.
Singer and songwriter Christopher Cross was born in San Antonio, Texas, and is now living in Austin. This is his fifth consecutive chart hit. At number 7 for its second week, The Best That You Can Do, the theme from the movie Arthur.
Once in your life, you find her.
Christopher Cross has been on AT40 for 5 weeks and the past 3 in the top 10. At number 7 with Arthur's theme as the countdown continues.
Casey's Coast to Coast, American Top 40.
We're on our way to number 1 and counting them down.
Number 6.
The San Francisco band Journey has hit the top 40 4 times before, but they didn't crack the top 10 until their current single. This has become their biggest hit to date. At number 6 for its second week, here's Who's Crying Now? Survey song number 6, second week in a row. That's Journey with Who's Crying Now? Well, now we're up to number 5, country superstar Ronnie Millsap's latest hit. But first, let me play a little piece of Ronnie's earliest appearance on both the pop and the country charts. If you listen carefully, you can hear him singing harmony with the main singer.
Daddy, you still got me, little Tommy. Together we'll find a brand new mommy. Daddy, daddy, please laugh again. Daddy, ride us on your bike again. Oh, daddy, please don't cry.
From 1970, that's Ronnie Millsap's voice in the background singing harmony behind the king of the charts, Elvis Presley. The song was Don't Cry, Daddy. Of course, Ronnie got no label credit on that record. He was just helping out a friend. His current hit, No Getting Over Me, already a number one country smash, is now in its fourth big week here on American Top 40 at number 5. Ronnie Millsap.
Well, you can walk out on me tonight.
4 consecutive weeks at number 5, 7 weeks in the top 10 for Ronnie Millsap's number one country hit, There's No Getting Over Me. The 4 biggest hits in the USA, coming right up.
This is Coast to Coast, American Top 40.
4 consecutive weeks at number 4, 5 weeks in the top 10 for Foreigner with Urgent. Well, now, as we get set to hear the 3 most popular songs in the USA, let's take a look at the tops of the other Billboard charts. Number 1 on the country chart is Tight Fitting Jeans by Conway Twitty. Number 1 on the soul chart is Endless Love by Diana Ross and Lionel Richie. Number 1 on the album chart is Tattoo You by the Rolling Stones. And on the pop singles chart, in the number 3 spot, where it's been now for 4 straight weeks, Stop Dragging My Heart Around, Stevie Nicks with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. Stop Dragging My Heart Around, 4th week at number 3 on American Top 40, Stevie Nicks with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. Last week, the number 1 song tied a rock era record. This week, it establishes a new one. Details coming up.
The hits from coast to coast,
Once a week with AT40, and you know how your favorite songs are doing on the national music scene. Like this one by Juice Newton. At number 2 for its 2nd week, Queen of Hearts. Juice Newton has been in the top 10 for 9 consecutive weeks. These past 2 weeks at number 2 with her hit, Queen of Hearts. Well, now on American Top 40, we're up to the number 1 song of the week. Last week, this single tied a record for the rock and roll era that had been established by the duo of Zager and Evans. Their huge hit in the year 2525 went to number 1 and stayed there for 6 weeks, the longest time any vocal duet spent at number 1. And last week, Zager and Evans' record was tied by another duet, by a man and a woman. This week, however, that man and woman establish a new record for the rock era. For the 7th consecutive week, the longest time a vocal duet has held the top spot, here are Diana Ross and Lionel Richie with the number 1 song in the land, Endless Love. Endless Smash, number 1 for its 7th week in a row. Endless Love by Diana Ross and Lionel Richie. And there you have them, the 40 most popular records in America as determined by Billboard magazine for the week ending September 26, 1981. American Top 40 is produced in Hollywood by Watermark Incorporated. Executive producer, Tom Rahm. Producer, Don Bastani. With Merrill Schindler, Matt Wilson, Jeff Leonard, Daryl Morton, Ron Shapiro, Alan Kaufman, and Renee Jean Hill. I'm Casey Kasem. Join me next week, and again, we'll count down the 40 most popular songs in the USA. Till then, keep your feet in the ground and keep reaching for the stars. And keep your radio tuned right where it is.
This classic presentation of Casey Kasem's American Top 40, The 80s, was digitally remastered by Shannon Lynn and produced by Toby James Petty. Special thanks to Kalila Dawkins, Rob Durkee, Pete Battistini, Scott Lakefield, Mike Savage, Michael Cross, Dave Nunez, and of course, the legend where the countdown began, K. Casey Kasem.